excited that you could all make it here this morning to celebrate with us as we demonstrate what we've been learning this year. Mauro, Hannah, Oreed, and I have had such a wonderful privilege of walking along your incredible third grade students as they have learned to decode and read and learn Rashi's commentary on the Chumash. The process that brought us to where we are today involved a lot of hard work on the students' part, but it was well worth the journey for them to becoming more accomplished and capable Torah learners, which they have. We started off with learning about the incredible life of Rashi HaKadosh, paying close attention to the many lessons in Midot Tovot and Kavod HaTorah that Rashi exemplified. We switched gears soon after and practiced the basic mechanics of decoding Rashi's famous script, which you can see on the table for me. And finally jumped right into exploring the text of the Torah, so concisely explained with Rashi's help. We realized how much more we can grasp in the Torah because of the special gift. The first part of our program this morning highlights a specific theme that we have studied. Through the art of dance, the students have connected to the power of the light of Torah and the light that Rashi brought into the world. A story is told of Rabbi Yitzchak, Rashi's father. Rabbi Yitzchak was a very, very poor man. One day, he found a precious gem that he knew he could sell and live off the money for generations to come. The local jeweler, however, couldn't afford the value of the gem and redirected Rabbi Yitzchak to the bishop for a sale. The bishop was willing to pay any price to acquire such a beautiful stone to decorate his cross. But when Rabbi Yitzchak heard for what purpose the stone would be used, he could not sell it to the bishop. He could not bring himself to do it. He knew that if he didn't, it was likely, though, that the bishop would just take it from him by force. So Rabbi Yitzchak threw the stone into the sea. It is said that a heavenly voice said to him then, "Because of your great sacrifice, you will be blessed with a son who will be light for the world." And indeed, as we all soon will hear why, Rashi was known as the light of the dark ages. I could not introduce the dances without introducing Mrs. Tamar Epstein, who worked so diligently with both classes and did such a phenomenal job as a student. Thank you very much.
Learning are centered on the theme of light. Rashi is known as the light of the dark ages. He received the light of Torah and the Emunah of the Jewish people. At this difficult time in history, his legacy shines to this day to work and lighten all who study Torah.
Oh, Yeah.
Tefillot Be'al Peh. When he was four, he knew all the Tefillot by heart.
Under the homage, the inside of every page of Talmud. right, she was so concise. And in his own script,
lots of stuff to all of you, to the parents, to the kids, grandparents, and families. It's really great to be here with all of you. These are some of my favorite things to do in my week, is to visit some parties like this. And I was going around the tables, as Mrs. Israel said, and it was wonderful to hear your great story. You guys did a great job. You deserve a round of applause. Since this is a Rashi party, I did want to share one thought with you, and I think it would be most appropriate to share it from a Rashi on this week's Parsha. And there's one Rashi on the Parsha that I think captures everything that I want to tell you guys this morning. Imagine for a second that you created the most incredible toy or game. And you worked on it for months and months, days and weeks leading up to it. You put it together, took it apart, making sure every single thing was working well. And you got up in front of this whole grade, and you come up here, you take out your toy, your game, you open it up, and you're ready to show it, and it fails. It doesn't work. That would be an awful feeling, right? Terrible feeling. You'd be so embarrassed. So actually, Rashi on this Parsha said that that's exactly what happened to Aaron HaKohen. Who knows who Aaron was? Whose brother was Aaron? Moshe's brother. So in our Parsha of Shmini, they talk about the building, the inauguration, the beginning ceremony of the Mishkan. Moshe had worked so hard, day in, day out, building this Mishkan, and they get to the eighth day of their celebration, their big party, not one day party, but eight day party, and Aaron goes in, and he starts to pray, starts to daven, he starts to bring the korbanos, and he realizes that it wasn't working. But Hashem's presence wasn't coming into the Mishkan, and he was devastated. So the pasuk says that Moshe went along with Aaron inside, and somehow they came out, and everything was working. What you see from this Rashi is something very beautiful. Moshe was able to help Aaron, and together they were able to become close to Hashem. When you partner with other people, and sometimes you need help, you can come sometimes much closer to Hashem. All of you, kids, you guys have a great partner that you achieved and that you acquired this year. And that partner is Rashi. Together, you and Rashi will be able to learn together every month of the Torah and be able to come closer to the Torah and closer to Hashem. There's one more piece of this pasuk and this Rashi. It says that after they helped each other and they came to be closer to Hashem, they came out and they blessed the rest of the Jewish people. And that's really what strikes me as so special this morning, because when you guys learn Torah, and you partner with Rashi to learn Torah and to come closer to Hashem, you're not just helping yourselves, you're bringing bracha to all of us. We count on you. It's because of you guys that we become blessed as a people when you learn Torah well. My bracha to you this morning is that all of you, with Rashi, without Rashi, should always be sweet, should always be interesting,
you know, boys and girls, all of us have teachers. I've had a lot of teachers because I was in school for a long time, and you have amazing teachers as well. One of my teachers is coming to speak next, and that's Mrs. Cox. And she taught Mrs. H and me a lot about how to be a principal. So we're very grateful to her, and we're very blessed and thankful that she comes to join us for the Rashi party. So we want to welcome Mrs. Cox.
I'll try it with the microphone. It's so overwhelming to me to see so many of you so grown up. It is beautiful. You danced amazingly well. You spoke clearly. You know your stuff. You've learned your Rashi. I am so proud of you and so happy for you. I'm also looking around and seeing some of the families for whom this is probably your last Rashi party for your own children. May you be blessed to see it for your grandchildren. So these are all, I think, my grandchildren and my great-grandchildren. I stopped differentiating. But I am so pleased. Now, why am I here wearing a shawl? I never wear shawl. Do you know where Rashi lived for a little bit of time? Not France? Where? I just pull out. Where else did you live in Europe?
Germany.
Germany. Does anyone know the name of the town? What's it called out?
Say it.
Worms.
Worms, right. In German, the W is pronounced like a V. Well, right down the road from Worms, sort of like if you like Rockville and Potomac, lived another family who probably about 100 years ago lived in a town, and they had a tablecloth on their table every day of the week except Shabbat. And when they came to the United States of America, they brought that tablecloth with them, and that family was my grandparents. And my mother grew up just down the road from where Rashi lived in Worms. She moved in with us, you know, quite a few years ago, and she brought this green tablecloth, and she told me all about it. I had never seen it growing up. She had always saved it. But, so this tablecloth is probably, except for what you have in your brains, this is a pretty close thing that lived near Rashi, or existed near Rashi. And it just reminds us that life goes on wherever you are, and you have something that this tablecloth eventually, the shawl, is eventually going to wear out. But what you have learned is never going to wear out. And I just hope that you will continue to grow and grow. And next year, what do you get next year? Last year you got Chumash. Next year, what do you get? Tanakh. Oh my goodness. So I hope to see you then. Even taller and even more knowledgeable, and have a wonderful, wonderful day and the rest of the year. And a great Pesach. Thank you very much.
Everybody here worked so hard to learn about Rashi. You know a lot. And everybody here also has a chumash that they received last year with Rashi's commentary. Now you have something else to tell you. What year and what day you had this very special, special ceremony. So your teachers have made you a Teudah, and it's one for each of you that reminds you of the special day that you had today. We're going to call you up, and you're going to take a picture with your teacher. I'm going to say your name, and then you can come over, and if your parent wants to take a picture, you'll have a chance to do that now. So that's the warning, parents. Ready? Ready? Camera time.